Hi guys, Ranger Jason Bentley here at the Conference Center at the Ligon Outdoor Center. I'd like to share some ideas with you to keep you active and interested in some science this summer. So one of the things that I like to do in the summertime is to cook. I like cooking year round, but because I'm an outdoorsy kind of a guy and I like to be outside and I like to do outdoor nature things, I also like to cook outside. So I'll cook on my campfire outside. I'll do a lot of grilling in the summertime outside. But one thing that I like to try at least a few times every summer is to use the sun to do some cooking. So I'm gonna share some ideas on how to build a solar oven. What's a solar oven? It's basically just a big reflector that you can use to harness the heat of the sun to be able to warm up and cook some of your food. Gonna show you a way that you can use the sun to make a solar oven, to either do an art project, like melt some crayons, or like Bryce and I are gonna do today, we're gonna warm up some s'mores and have a summertime treat. Well, all you need is a pizza box, some tape, and some aluminum foil, a glass bowl, a sheet of black paper as a heat absorbing source, and then some sort of cup to either put your crayons in for your art project, or if you're gonna, like we're gonna do, I just have a graham cracker set down there with my s'mores cooking on it. Let's go over and look at the stages of creation to be able to make your very own solar oven. We're back with the solar ovens here, and if you follow the link that I'm sharing, you can see the printed directions on there. But I want to walk through you some stages of construction on here. Again, we started with a pizza box. Such like any other pizza box that you get, you know, when your pizza comes in it and you pick it up. So the pizza box is flat. You have to put it together, fold it in the proper way. But what we're gonna do to help that is we're gonna tape all these corners. We're gonna get some duct tape and we're gonna secure these up and tape them down to make it a lot sturdier. So here's one that already the tape has been put around the corners to help hold it together. The corners are now not going to come apart when we're adding on the rest of our reflective foil, okay? So, if you'll notice on this one, the sides have been taken off. And this is what we're gonna make for our support arms, okay? So I've already moved these tabs off of each side on here. Those are our arms. We're gonna wrap those in foil too. The more reflective material we can get on this box, the better we're gonna be able to harness the heat of the sun and to use for our projects. Now over here, we have some that are already been wrapped up. We've already wrapped those arms with foil, just took a little tape, wrapped it around and held it on there, okay? And then once these are wrapped with foil and our box, as you can see, it's nothing fancy. It doesn't have to be pretty. I just took a piece of aluminum foil, taped it onto the back side of the box. Doesn't have to go all the way around because we're just using this section of our box. This is our oven right here. So it doesn't have to be all the way around, just on the inside cooking area. So I've placed foil on the bottom and taped it into place. I've placed foil across the top of our cover, our lid, and taped it into place. And then the next step would be to tape on our arms onto the sides to use that as our support, okay? So as you can see here on the next step, we've covered up our arms with foil, we've covered up our box, the inside, the reflective side with foil, and we've taped our arms into place. So this lid cannot move. As you can see, it's all taped on and holding into the place. And again, it doesn't have to be real fancy looking. It doesn't have to be perfect. If it's some wrinkles in there, some tape's not in place, it's no big deal. It's the inside area that's the important part that we have some cover on here. We have another box going outside right now that we've set up earlier. We've been using the sun to do our cooking, and we've been keeping track of how fast those temperatures have been coming up and keeping track of that on our time and temperature chart here. So on our time and temperature chart, we'll start at 0 minutes when we set it up, whatever time of day that was, what the outdoor temperature was, what the inside temperature of the oven was, because we have a thermometer setting in there that'll tell us how hot it is. And then you can describe what it is, your item that you're cooking, and what it looks like, what the consistency of it was. Are you melting crayons? Are you making a different food project? Are you warming up a pizza? So there's different things that you want to document and record. So this is a scientific study that we're going to record how long it took and what all of our data was. So the more detailed you can be put on there, the better it will be. Here are the basic stages of construction. As you can see, it's very simple. It's not going to take you very long to put this together. Okay guys, welcome back. We're outside here standing in a nice sunny spot, and we've had our solar oven set up for about 30 minutes already, and we've been keeping track of the time. When we first set this out, our thermometer said that it was 80 degrees on it, and once it reached the sun and was sitting out here, that so slowly started climbing up, and we've already got it up to 120 degrees inside the sun where it's reflecting down. So we have two different items in here, and we're doing a little comparison, which one's gonna cook faster or be ready quicker. And it's much what we expected. Our s'more with the chocolate and the marshmallow only took about 15 to 20 minutes for that chocolate to melt and that marshmallow to get nice and gooey. And it's gonna be delicious, I'll guarantee it. But our crayon art project over here next to it is taking a lot longer. The crayons are melting down nicely, and it's starting to form one big clump of crayon wax. But because the crayons are so much denser, they're heavier, they're obviously not gonna melt as quick as what a chocolate bar would. So that's a good time comparison. And on our chart, we show that. Our food item is preparing much quicker than our artwork item. So we've documented that down on our chart and kept track of when it was ready, at what time, and at what temperature. So keep track of your project too. If it's not melting down as quick as you'd like it, maybe it's too early in the morning, maybe it's not sunny enough, maybe you're in too much shade. So again, you have to compare and see what you can do to change things. And that's part of what science is. Not everything is exactly the way you thought it was going to be when you started it. So keep track of your records, and good luck with your project, and let's see how long it takes your oven to melt down your projects.